Okay, so this lesson shows you how you can use live object model so you can tailor make your own device using LOM. So we don't have to ask your teacher every time, I want to do this. So the first thing you want to do is to get to the LOM big thing. And the easiest thing to find it, I'm sure it's a better way, go to cycling site, click max 8, and you can actually search, I thought, yes, and then say LOM, and it will pop up, object model, here you are. Or you can just Google a live object model, and it will pop up. So then you have this jungle thing over here. Now it's you can click on these things to find things. Anyway, so we'll get back to that. But let's open something here, and I'm going to make a new device, OD device, and M4L, and open that. And here we go. These things, we're just gonna move you down there and make it a little bigger so you can you can see better. Okay, so now remember from the last lesson that I have live path, the master of all things. And what we're gonna do, for example, is let's say I have some kind of an audio device that I want to control, any parameter, right? So let's say, yeah, sure, audio filter. And I want to see when I select something or click on something, how does it know? And there are lots of already made devices, but it'll be nice for you to be able to do it yourself, so you don't have to, you know, depend on people. So I want my children. Okay, so get children, as we did this before. And then type path live_set and view, because if you like to go back to your live object model thing, here it says application song view, so this is what you want. If you click on it, it says song view, okay? Or you can just simply say, even before that, you can, okay, let's go from the beginning. So you can delete your view thing and have a path and performance print object. Make sure to connect on the right inlet so you can see. And then let's say click on live set and then get children. So my children are these people. So I have all kinds of stuff, and here you are, the view. Okay, so this is what we need. Now you can add a word view, and let's see what comes up. Click on that and get my children, and see there are selected parameters, selected whatever. So here you are, selected parameter is what I want. Yeah, so just added the selected parameter to the path. The path live_set view selected_set parameter, right? So now we can move on to actually doing it. So live object, let's connect live object. Remember this one with the middle one is sending the two words, ID and the path number. So I'm gonna connect it here, and then just add this to message, get name if you like. It's not necessary, but this one is the important one, get path. And now be careful, do not separate these two words. Get path is one word. It is annoying, but that's the way it is. So let's say I am just going to connect the message box so you can actually see what's coming up. And let's try this. So I'm just going to save this. And let's try. So I have audio filter connected, whatever this is. And let's say I want to control filter frequency, for example. So I'm going to select it, just clicked on it. And then I'm just going to say, well, selected parameters. So I'm going to click on that. And let's say what it this says. Name is, name frequency. Right? Oh, it's too small. I should have made it bigger. Let's say like this. So let's see. Let's try again. Filter, I'm going to select and then click select a parameter. And then let's say what is the name is select frequency. Good. And then select path. Ah, it says path is live set track 2 because learned all of the zero Mari. So 0, 1, 2. Right? This is the track 2. It's track 0, 1, track 2. Device 0. Again, learned all of the 0. This is the first device. So it's 0. Right? Device 0. Parameter 5. So that is assigned to be number 5. Now we found out. So, okay, let's try. For example, how can I turn this device on off? So let's try that. So this one, I just click on it and then click this guy and then name is device on, right? So get path, look, see? So that is track 2, 0, 1, 2, 0, device 0, parameter 0. That is his name. Now let's make it so that we can actually use this. So let's try again with a new something. Let's choose something like device on and off. This button, how do you turn this on and off remotely? So you go to your max, it snaps to the back. Okay, so I just selected that. So what is it? It's a path, live set track 2, device 0, parameter 0. Device is 0 because the first one it's 0 and this is named parameter 0. So that's all good. And then what you need to do is go back to working with live path again. So let's add, actually I can just copy paste this and connect this path to the live path. It's a little zigzag, but can just make this smaller and go over here. So now all I need to do is to set, oops, where are you, set, okay, set value $1 because I'm going to be changing them, and add a value. So in this case I suppose it's 0 or 1 because on or off this guy. So let's see, it's right now it's on, so let's turn it. Ah, I need to first click this and then 0 1 0 oops 1, click this, I mean this message box. Okay, so we can make it a little more usable so you don't have to keep clicking things. I mean, you know, you can go fancy any way you want, but one thing you can do maybe is to add this mighty trigger object. So we need to bang the message after you send this huge list of text. So I want to put this not directly, but first send in the text name. And then send this text to the live path. So this way, I can just do that. So let's try with something else. Let's say I want to change. Okay, so whatever this is, resonance or something. So I just click that, and then I go here, and what is the path? Wham. Okay, so parameter is 6, and I don't know how this has changed, but maybe this may be between 0 and 1. Oops. Yeah, so apparently it's 0 and 1 or minus 1. So let's connect a float number instead. You can have either. I guess the float number is safer because everyone has 1 or 0. Okay, so 0, 1, yeah. I think it's 0, between 0 and 1, so you see this guy, right? So let's do another one, just to be sure. Whatever this is, release, so I'll click that. Live set, get path, and now, is this also 0 and 1? No, this is more, a bigger number. So there you go, see? So you can do that. Let's go back to auto filter. D device on or off again. So get paths and 0 or 1, right? So even if you want to go even fancier, one click thing, you can just add a trigger object to trigger bang after sending the list yet again, and stick this between here, and this goes in here, and I can get rid of the children. Oh no, children is gotten rid of, and the bang goes to the get pass. If you don't care about the name, you can just delete that, and now you have more streamlined version. So let's save this and see if this works. Let's try again. Envelope, I want to choose that. There you go. If that's the one, okay, well, let's see. Yep. So this is between 1 and 0. No, it's not even. Okay, so there you go. Go back to this one. I want that. Then it will be 0 or 1, right? So that's it. Now I hope you know how to do this yourself, so you don't have to keep asking questions to your teacher. Okay, bye.